poisoning, just take 3-4 minutes time and let me know about it. Okay, I will call any one of you, then you can let me.
Can you repeat, sir? ARP
ARP spoofing, SPOOFING, or ARP flooding, or ARP poisoning, everything is same. Okay, did you get it?
Yes sir, thank you so much.
Okay, Gayatri, are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you tell me what is ARP spoofing or flooding? Basically, ARP is address resolution.
I don't know.
What were you doing? I have given you time, right? and given time for you to search. You don't know, you should have searched.
I'll do it.
Chaturya? Am I audible? Chaturya? Monish? Okay, anyone else who know who have at least researched something on ARP spoofing or ARP flooding, what it is? Can anyone tell me?
Sir, it's basically like flooding ARP requests in the LAN and mapping a genuine IP address with the attacker's MAC address. So that's basically ARP spoofing.
Yeah, yeah, right. Any other answers?
Sir, I didn't get correctly like what Vishnu said. I read only, I spent some few minutes only, like what I understood is the attacker will be misguiding the sender. Like he will be linking the receiver's IP address with his MAC address so that whatever the sender will be sending, the messages won't be going to, the ARP messages won't be going to the receiver. Instead, the attacker will be receiving. Isn't it that, sir? Like,
I will explain it. Basically, what is ARP? Address resolution protocol, which maps your IP address to the right MAC address. Okay, so that means in your local area network, if you have if it's a very brand new network, you have not communicated to any other devices initially, what happens, you will send a request, say A sends a request to C. Okay, there are A, B, C, D, four different devices in that particular network. A wants to send a data to C. So A doesn't know the IP address or where exactly it is located in the particular network. A know it, but A basically, okay, let me put it in this way. If I draw a diagram, it will be easy for you to understand. Can you see the screen, student?
Yes, sir.
So basically, suppose you have a switch, okay? This is your switch, and there are four devices connected to this. The five devices. Okay. So let me call it as A, B, C, D. Five end devices are connected to it. It is a brand new network. Okay. A sends a packet and A wants to send it to C. Okay, A wants to send it to C. So this switch doesn't know. A has added its MAC address, its destination IP address, everything it has added, but this particular switch doesn't know where exactly C is, because this is port number 1, port number 2, port number 3, port number 4, and port number 5. Okay. This A sends a packet to this switch. Switch doesn't know whether C is in port number 2, port number 3, port number 4, or port number 5. Is that clear? Because its ARP table is empty now. This is ARP table. Okay. ARP table is empty now. So what it does, this switch will broadcast. Switch will broadcast it to B, C, D, and E. So what happens initially, all the other devices apart from A receives that packet. B will look at its destination address and there is no match with it. So B will just neglect it. Okay. Then D also will neglect it. Then this E also will neglect it. C, upon accepting that packet, it has to send an acknowledgement, right? So it sends an acknowledgement saying that I have received it and hence I had to send the acknowledgement. That acknowledgement should go to A. Is that clear? So in ARP table, what will happen? At port number 1, initially, A will be there. Is that clear? Because this switch has received a packet from A in port number 1, it will enter it. At port number 1, there is a system called A with so-and-so IP address. It will add the IP address. So this will be the MAC address mapping. Is that clear? Here there will be a MAC address, the other side will be IP address. So in that particular port number. Then when C responds, this ARP table entry will again get updated. At port number 3, there is a device called C with so-and-so IP address and MAC address. Is that clear? So that is basically ARP table. Like that, there will be self-learning, and for this self-learning, ARP protocol will help. ARP will be keep on exchanging the messages. Am I clear, students? Is it clear about ARP now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now, what is the benefit of attacking this? Okay, so all network devices have an ARP table. A short-term memory for all the IP address and MAC addresses the device has already matched together. Is that clear? That's a mapping. Okay. The ARP table ensures that the device doesn't have to repeat ARP requests for devices it already communicated with. So in this case, what happens? I said to you initially it will be a broadcast, right? Second time, there is no need for broadcasting it. Is it not? It is just a direct unicast for that particular device if ARP table entry is already there. If it is not there, then only you have to go for broadcast. So what happens? So an attacker basically involves constructing forged ARP replies, okay, for convincing a target computer to send frames destinated to computer A to instead go to computer B. That means an attacker will bombard ARP request continuously. That is basically ARP flooding. In ARP spoofing, all are same. Actually, you are manipulating the ARP table. Is that clear? In the table, what happens? For this particular MAC address, this is the IP address. Like how? Like that, there will be small modifications done by the attacker to, instead of sending a packet to A, attacker will receive it. Is that clear? That is how it happens. So, how do you mitigate this? Install ARP watch. There is something called as a tool called as ARP watch. Is that clear? ARP-WATCH, which will help a network to manage the ARP request and keep an eye on ARP request and ARP table continuously. Is that clear? So the second option is install IDS tools. Is that clear? So IDS is intrusion detection system. Please make a note of it. IDS means intrusion detection system. So install IDS tools such as SNORT, S-N-O-R-T. That is one example of IDS tool. So as I said, you have to install ARP watch. You have to install IDS tools. And finally, you have to configure your firewall properly to avoid alting. Is that clear, students? That's about ARP spoofing. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we'll go to the next one. So next one is quite known type of an attack to everyone, eavesdropping. Okay, just I will give 2 minutes for this. Eavesdropping is a attack. Let me know about what is eavesdropping. I'll give you 2 minutes and I'll call your name. Please don't say that I don't know when you call your name. Okay, I'm giving time for you to search on that. Don't waste your time. Okay. Navya? Navya, are you there in the class? My audible student?
Yes, sir.
So what I observe is there are a lot of students who are attending but not participating. Right? Abhishek, what is eavesdropping?
Excuse me, sir. Hello?
Yeah, am I audible, Abhishek?
Hello, sir.
Hello, am I audible, Abhishek? Hello.
Hear me?
Yeah. Vishnu.
Sir, eavesdropping is basically when a sender sends a packet to, like, say A and B are communicating, and A is sending something to B. Somebody passively observes what is being sent from A to B. Like, it's basically it's like packet sniffing, or basically tracking the packets. That's eavesdropping, sir. So we can avoid this by encrypting whatever we are sending.
You are absolutely right. Basically, eavesdropping refers to an act of listening to private conversations while not being detected. Exactly, yeah. Listening to private conversations while not being detected. That's the meaning of eavesdropping. So, how do you protect your data or private data while it is in transit? So you have to encrypt it. That's the major way you can protect it. Then you have to implement adequate network security. That means the same. So you can use some scanning tools or perform penetration testing to identify vulnerability to interception of messages transmitted. Is that clear? There is something called as penetration testing, where you can use some scanning tools to do that, where you can identify where you have vulnerabilities and to fix it. Is that clear? So that's about eavesdropping. So the next, yeah.
Like this is dropping can be like we can see it in various attacks, no, sir? Like man in the middle attack, and then probably some others also. It is not like a specific attack, but it is just a technique, no, sir?
Yes.
Yes. I also read how to prevent eavesdropping. Like there are techniques like firewalls, like except the encryption one, and then even Wireshark is kind of eavesdropping only, no, sir? I see that it is also a tool to prevent eavesdropping. So can you elaborate on that?
See, Wireshark is not a tool to prevent eavesdropping. Wireshark is a packet sniffer. That means whatever goes out of your network and whatever comes into your network, you can access it. Is that clear? So it has to run in a device, through a device. Is that clear? Basically, in eavesdropping, what happens? Somebody is in the medium. Okay. So your packets are, when your packets are in the transit in the medium, somebody will listen or somebody will see your data. Is that clear? So, there is
excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Can you please make everyone attendees first?
Come on. Okay, so there is no relation with respect to eavesdropping and any packet sniffing tool. Okay, so Wireshark we use to figure out what is coming in and what is going out, where it is exactly going out, from where you are getting in, all those things you can see, but eavesdropping is totally different. Am I clear?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Next type of an attack is root table modification. Root table modification. The name itself will tell you, but take 1 or 2 minutes and find out what it is. Root table modification.
Can you repeat that, sir?
Root table modification.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, can anyone tell me what is root table modification?
So it's basically modifying the values of the root table.
Modifying the?
The roots in the root table. And it's achieved through editing the information of the routing packets.
Okay. Basically, a routing table is an electronic document, right? That stores the routes to various nodes in the computer network. So what will attacker do? Attacker might modify or delete a root or add a separate root in the root table modification attack. So basically, the attacker will gain access to device routing table and perform authorization operation, like root deletion, addition, or modification. What will attacker achieve from this? This makes the table entries invalid and may also lead the denial of service attack. Is that clear? This will lead to denial of service attack, and also an attacker, by changing the root, can guide all the packets to go into his system. Is that clear? So these are some of the effects of root table modification. How do you mitigate it? Constantly observe routing traffic and the list of nodes the router trusts. Is that clear? You have to constantly observe the routing traffic. There are management tools for it, like SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol. Those kind of protocols will take care of it. There is no requirement of human intervention to handle this, okay? Then you have to use strong cryptographic authentication methods to because somebody accessing a routing table, no, you have to be very careful. Only the legitimate user should access the routing table. Is that clear? So access to routing table should be protected first. So when you protect the access to the routing table by any unauthorized user, you can avoid this type of attack. Am I clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Next type of attack is backdoor. Next type of attack is backdoor. BACKDOOR. So that is also a quite common type of attack. Just take 1 or 2 minutes and tell me what it is. Backdoor attack. Yeah, can anyone tell me what is backdoor attack? Anyone? Okay.
Sir, it is a kind of malware that they inject in the system in which it is not really noticeable. Like if there is some ransom or phishing attack, then it can be noticeable, but this backdoor attack, it cannot be noticed. And then they will using that malware, like they'll put it in the form of some software update or any download. That way it will be merged inside that, and then it won't be so easy to identify it. And how we can prevent it is by having a firewall or by doing network monitoring. Like if any command is like getting some information which is not supposed to be given or something, then network monitoring can we can detect what commands are being used, and so we can prevent it before any unnecessary data goes outside.
Yeah, you are right. If I want to put it in another way, backdoor is a method used to bypass the normal authentication, okay, or secure remote access or gain access to text while not being detected. That's why it is called as backdoor. Something is running in your system which you gain access to that without being detected. That is called as backdoor. If you have, even though if you have authentication methods, still those methods will be bypassed. Is that clear? So how to protect or prevent from this? Accept systems only from trusted sources. That means connection only through trusted sources. Or you can use you can perform regular integrity checks on a program in use to ensure that they have not been altered. That's what you said, malware. You will be adding malware that will run in your system. So how to check that? You have to check for the integrity of the program or data what is there in your system. So if the integrity is proved, then there is no malware in it. Okay, so that's how you can protect it. Or as you said, we can have a lot of a good firewall mechanism to detect and avoid it. So that's about backdoor attacks today.
Huh?
Yeah.
Sahana mentioned about ransomware and phishing. Ransomware can also be called a backdoor attack, but just that it was not hidden. Like it was so done on a large scale that people were able to detect it towards the end. But that also can be considered as a backdoor attack, no, sir? And also phishing, can it be called as a backdoor attack, sir?
No. They are not backdoor attacks.
Both, sir?
Yes, both.
Can you tell what is ransomware attack? It was so much into news, but I'm not sure how it actually works.
I have a meeting now. Immediately, I have to join. In the next class, I will discuss that. Okay, please remind me in the next class.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
We are starting with the first year classes today.
No, sir. Yes.
Okay, students. Then take care. I'll meet you in the next class. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.